So I'm reading for sign of Taurus, all that I need to know. Moving forward, so what are you guys going through in terms of your soulmate relationship? Let's take three cards for you, three cards for your person, and then we'll see where you guys are in terms of this connection. So what Taurus going through? First card we have for you is a Temperance card. We have the Knight of Swords, which tells me that you guys are very trying to focus more on your future than your past. Okay, you guys are trying to heal yourself as of now. Okay, and with Knight of Swords, you guys are wanting to move forward now. Okay, in the past, I see you trying to juggle too many things, trying to see which option was right for you, or which person was right for you, or which situation was best for you. But right now you're more clear, you have that balance, or you are focusing on that balance, that healing. With Knight of Swords, I also see you having a vision and having a plan and wanting to move in a certain direction. Okay, what else do we see coming up for Taurus? With the Star card, you are wanting to keep that hope and faith alive, that this connection that you are a part of, or this plan, or this business, or this career that you are a part of, you can move things ahead in some which way. In the recent past, you are trying to be in control, you are not wanting to let go of any loose situation. Okay, even if your person was behaving a bit sneaky, bit like trying to get a reaction out of you, you were not giving any reaction, to be honest. Okay, you were keeping on your ground, doing your own thing, not wanting to say much, do much, just behaving unbothered. Right now I see you focused, healed, in a better place, and very much moving forward. Okay, if they cannot come with you, or they are not possibly ready to be a part of you, you're going to move ahead, you're not going to wait on them forever. Okay, one card in terms of your connection, your relationship, where things are going. But I see a major focus being healing. Okay, you won't be a part of something or someone that is kind of pulling you down. With Knight of Pentacles, your relationship has been extremely slow. Okay, this person hasn't been taking any sort of action towards you. Maybe you were the one who was doing everything. They seem to be having or being a part of it, but they did not do anything about it. Okay, for some of you, this was very sexual, but nothing emotional. One more card in terms of the energy, overall energy. Taurus and their soulmate. Overall energy with the Justice card, I do feel many of you guys are going to focus on balance. And if you still feel that this connection cannot give you that balance, cannot give you that peace, things are not equal, I see you moving in a different direction. I don't see you holding on to it. Okay? You're not going to be sad and depressed about it. You're going to just move on. Okay? One more card in terms of your person, what are they going through? Okay, your person, I believe, has been emotionally distant, emotionally unavailable. Maybe they were all about words, but when it comes to taking action, they just don't do shit. Okay, one card for how they're thinking about you, one card for how they're thinking about Taurus. With Eight of Wands, please clarify, the Eight of Wands is either message or staying away. Please clarify the Eight of Wands, Eight of Cups. A lot of eights here. So the number eight might be kind of significant to you. Okay. With the Magician in the reverse, this person is very, very sneaky. Okay. You cannot trust them completely. Even if you want to, I think you should not. Okay, reason being, they have something on their mind, they have some bad plan, evil plan on their mind. Okay, this person will want to keep things sexual, want to keep in communication with you, but might not give in emotionally, might still trigger you, trick you. What I'm trying to say, I'm getting a very narcissistic energy coming from this person's side. Okay, some of you, this person is an Aries or a Sagittarius. Okay. More card. In terms of their feelings, what do they have for you? What do they truly have for Taurus? Queen of Pentacles. Please clarify the Queen of Pentacles. What do they have in their heart space for Taurus? Okay. Ten of Wands. So this has just been like a responsibility for them. They were not really in love with you, rather it was more like an attachment. Some of you, this is your husband or wife that you're dealing with, someone you already married to, but they look at it more like a responsibility than love. Okay, to be very honest, in terms of their headspace, what is happening? In terms of their headspace, what do we see happening? Fool, please clarify the Fool card for me. Page of Swords. So I still see very much a defensive energy coming from their side. They more or less want an open connection, open relationship. Even if they are married to you, I do not see them investing emotionally. They just want to go with the flow without any plans, without any, you know, solid things that you could look up to. Okay, I still feel with the Fool and the Page of Swords, this person doesn't care much. Okay, they are very careless when it comes to this connection, and they have been careless. They've been acting like a fucking child, to be honest. Okay, it seemed very one-sided in the past, and I don't think you're happy. You're just trying to heal yourself, fix yourself, and maybe that you're wanting to move in a different direction altogether. Okay, one card for their overall intentions towards Taurus. What are their overall intentions towards Taurus, please? Yeah, I still see this person wanting to keep you in the dark, not telling you what is going on with them, what they want from you, their intentions, anything. This person is keeping you in the dark. This person is keeping you stuck. Okay, one more card. In terms of action, what action do I want to take towards you now? In terms of action, with Six of Pentacles, they might somewhat put in energy to keep you holding on. That's their plan, to put in somewhat, you know, some amount of energy to make you believe that this thing is still on. They might behave sweet with you, warm with you, and out of nowhere, you're like, what is this now? Okay, but I don't see this person willingly wanting to give you commitment. Even if this is marriage, this is basically going nowhere, darling. I'm really sorry, but this has been the most fucked up reading ever that I've done for, you know, any zodiac sign for the month of May. Okay, one more card. In terms of what can you expect from this person, what can Taurus expect from this person? Death. Please clarify the death card. Person is not willing to change, so that much I could tell you. They are being very silent, very secretive, very much a narcissist. Okay, someone who's hiding things from you just to keep you away from reality. That's their plan. I don't see this person changing. What can they offer you, like, to the max? What can they offer you? Yeah, this person is sneaky as fuck. I'm going to be very straightforward. You cannot trust this person. They will just keep you holding on to something that might not even last. Okay, very, very sneaky energy. Okay, one card for how do they view you? How do they truly view you, Taurus? I think this has been the worst reading I've done this whole year, to be honest. They view you as someone who's good looking, who's passionate, someone who might be really doing well in terms of their career, their profession. Okay, someone who's really sexual, good looking, successful, passionate. Okay, and yes, in terms of the connection, how do they view the connection they share with you? And they may still believe that you want this connection with them. You still want this connection, you're still holding on to it. Okay. If you are married to this person, they are just going to give you this. I don't see them like putting in any sort of extra effort. With the Strength card, they are going to want to hold on to you for all that they could get out of you. You know what I'm trying to say? So yes, in terms of that, what should you be knowing about this connection? Okay. Half truth, keeping secrets. Just like I told you, this person is hiding a lot from you. One more card. What else should you be knowing? This person is choosing their work life over love life. Okay, last card we have for you. Insecurity, out of my league. So for some of you, you may be really good looking and this person might not, or you may be really successful and this person might not, or you may be something real good and they might be not, and that insecurity kind of gets in the way. Okay, so yes, one more card, one last card, because this thing is moving forward. So some of you, this person might have options. Okay, they may already be looking up elsewhere, so please be careful. They are hiding something for sure. Okay, so yes, this was your reading for the sign of Taurus, all that you need to know. I'm sorry if it came off a bit negative, but I like to speak the whatever I see in the cards. I don't like to hide or sugarcoat. That has been me for the longest time. Okay, and this is how I read. If you resonated and if you really consider this helpful, please hit the like button. Do let me know in the comment section. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. All those who want a personal reading with me, please reach out to my website or my WhatsApp or my email, and we could move things forward. Thank you so much for coming in, and I hope you have a great month ahead. Cheers.